start when you are ready.
Видно екран?
Yes, it's okay. But for full, please do for full account.
Не можна. Якщо можна, я так. На повний екран не видно?
Гаразд, все гаразд, все гаразд.
Окей.
Okay. Thank you. Good evening, dear participant of conference. My talk is called Groups with the Restriction on the Generalized Norm and is dedicated to the memory of my teacher and mentor, Peter Mikolaevich Luman. At first, I will make a few introductory remarks on the problem. In group theory, a special place is occupied by the result concerning the study of the properties of characteristic subgroups. In particular, the central group, the derived subgroup, Latinus subgroup, and other, and the influence of their properties on the structure of the group. Currently, the list of such characteristic subgroups can be supplemented by a different sigma norm of a group. So let's give a definition. Let sigma be a system of subgroup of a group that have a certain theoretical group properties. For example, the system sigma may consist of all subgroup of the group of all non-abelian and all non-cyclic or all non-subnormal subgroup subgroups. The sigma norm of group G is the intersection of normalizes of all subgroup of group G included in the system sigma. Sigma norm for specific system subgroup sigma can be considered by algebraists of different countries during the 100 year, but the general concept of sigma norm for all arbitrary system of subgroups sigma was introduced only at the end of the 20th century by Feder Lehmann. It's clear that any sigma norm is a characteristic subgroup of a group. It contains the center of a group and is a group in which all subgroups of sigma are normal. But the set of such subgroups can be empty. If you know the structure of the sigma norm and the nature of its embedding in the group, then in many cases, we can characterize the structure of the whole group. For example, if such norm coincides with a group, all the subgroup of system sigma are normal in group, provided that sigma is non-empty. Group with this property were first considered in the late 19th century in the papers of Dedekind. He described finite group in which all subgroups are normal. Now group with such properties are called Dedekind group. However, the systematic study of group is an arbitrary normal system of subgroups was continued only in the second half of the 20th century. And a significant contribution to their study was made by the Kyiv group school headed by Sergei Chernikov. So nowadays for many system of subgroup sigma, the structure of groups that coincide with their sigma norm is known. Therefore, it would be natural to ask the questions of studying the property of groups that have proper sigma norm. This problem was first formulated by Baer in the 30s of the last century. He considered the sigma norm for the system sigma of all subgroups of a group and called the corresponding sigma norm the norm of a group G and denoted it by N of G. It's clear that such norm is contained in all other sigma norms, and sigma norms can be considered generalization of Bell's norm. The further study of sigma norm was continued in the works of Geschitz, Violant, and Kep. In the 1550s, they introduced and investigated generalized norm for the system of all maximal, all subnormal, and all maximal abelian subgroups of a finite group, and the corresponding norm were called delta group of G, Violant subgroup, and a norm of group G. The increase in interest in the study of different sigma norm of a group took place at the end of the last and the beginning of this century. This can be explained by the fact that the inner structure of sigma norm for a number of system sigma became known. Among such new norms, we will allocate a norm of non-cyclic subgroups of group G, this norm introduced by Lehmann, a norm of non-abelian subgroup of group D, or mesonorm M of G. Its norm is investigated by Marie Giovanni De Falco and Kurdachenko, a norm on infinite subnormal subgroup, and others. The subject of the study was the inner properties of this norm and their outside properties, in particular, the influence of restrictions that satisfy this norm on the characteristics of the whole group. Here are two notions that are closely related to the norm of the group. One of them is the concept of the invariator of subgroup H in group G. It's concept introduced by Igor Subotin. It called the intersection of normalizers in G of all subgroups of a group H. If H coincides with D, the invariator is exactly the Bell's norm of group G. The second concept in the notion of H norm of group introduced by Falco, Giovanni, and Nozella. They called H norm of group the intersection of the normalizers of all subgroup of a group G containing H. If H is identity subgroup, then the H norm is the Bell's norm of the group. These two concepts are easy to generalize if we consider the intersection of normalizers of subgroup of the group that have a certain theoretical group property as and accordingly are contained in subgroup H or contains this subgroup. Baer noted that the restriction imposed on the norm of the group to some extent affect the properties of the whole group. If the norm of group contains a subgroup of quaternion, then the group will not have element of infinite order and the element of order 8. In addition, in group without a center, the norm is an identity subgroup. With some restrictions imposed on the generalized norm, it is also possible to characterize the properties of the whole group. Let us consider the properties of one such generalized norm, the norm of decomposable subgroup of a group, and investigate its influence on the properties of groups. The intersection of normalizers of all decomposable subgroup of group G will be called the norm of decomposable subgroup, and we will denote it by NGD. Recall that the subgroup is decomposable if it can be represented as a direct product of two non-trivial factors. For group that don't contain the composable subgroup, we consider that G is equal to NGD. It follows from the definition of norm NGD that in the case of NGD coincides with G, in the group G, all decomposable subgroup are normal, or the system of such subgroup is empty. Non-abelian group with this property were studied by Lehmann and were called DE groups. So the structure of the norm of decomposable subgroup or group that coincides with this norm is known. Under the additional condition of local nilpotency and non-dedekindness, it is described by the next propositions. The first statement characterizes the structure of norm NGD of periodic group. In this case, the norm of the decomposable subgroup under this restriction is the primary group and its structure is norm. Therefore, if such norm in the periodic group is locally nilpotent and non-primary, then it is automatically Dedekind group. The second statement give us the structure of the norm NGD in the non-periodic case. We have two types of groups, both of which are non-periodic. It follows from proposition two that if in non-periodic group, the norm of decomposable subgroup is a periodic locally nilpotent group, then it is Dedekind. So the structure of the norm of the NGD and the structure of groups that coincide with this norm under the condition of non-Dedekindness and local nilpotency is known. So it is natural to investigate the properties of groups in which this norm is proper subgroup. We first present several properties of groups in which the norm of the decomposable subgroup is non-Dedekind and locally nilpotent. It was found that under specified restriction, a group contained non-primary abelian subgroup only if and only if such subgroups are contained in this norm. In the class of periodic locally nilpotent group, the existence of decomposable subgroup in group is directly related to the existence of such subgroups in the norm NGD. If this norm is non-Dedekind and does not contain such subgroups, then group G does not contain them too. The next theorem also describes the properties of periodic groups with the specified restriction of the norm of the decomposable subgroup. It is proved that in this class of groups, each decomposable subgroup has a non-identity intersection with the norm NGD. The group does not contain non-primary cyclic subgroups, and under the condition of non-identity of the center of group, the group D is primary. In addition, if the group contains abelian non-cyclic subgroups, then the norm of the decomposable subgroup of group coincides with the norm of abelian non-cyclic subgroups. Recall that the norm of abelian non-cyclic subgroup is the intersection of the normalizers of all abelian non-cyclic subgroup of the group. Theorem 4 describes a periodic locally nilpotent group in which the norm of the decomposable subgroups is non-Dedekind. It is proved that all such groups are primary. Moreover, if under this restriction group does not contain contain decomposable subgroups, then it is a quaternion to groups of order greater than H. This is the result of the theorem finding. If a group contains the composable subgroup, then it is a P group. And its norm of decomposable subgroup coincides with the norm of abelian non-cyclic subgroup. It's theorem 6. The next theorem describes infinite periodic local nilpotent group with non-Dedekind norm of decomposable subgroup. All of them are P group of one of the type of this theorem and are the finite extension of quasi-cyclic P group. In the last two cases, such groups have a proper norm of decomposable subgroup. The structural characterization of infinite locally finite non-primary, so not locally nilpotent group, in which the norm of decomposable subgroup is non-Dedekind and locally nilpotent subgroup is given by theorem H. It was proved that this group are Frobenius group, groups with an infinite primary kernel, which coincide with the norm of decomposable subgroup. And the non-invariant factor, it's a subgroup H, is a cyclic subgroup of the order, which is a power of the prime number. Consider the properties of the non-periodic group with the same restriction on the norm of the decomposable subgroup. Theorem H9 gives the structural description of the non-periodic local nilpotent group with a non-Dedekind norm of decomposable subgroup. It was found that such groups are nilpotent of class 2 and coincide with the norm NGD. As a corollary, in the class of non-periodic local nilpotent group, the condition of non-Dedekindness of this norm is equivalent to the condition of normality of all decomposable subgroups in groups. In the case of non-periodic non-local nilpotent groups, it was proved that there are only three types with the specified restriction of this norm. It's a result of theorem 10. All of these types are finite cyclic extensions of this norm. Finally, consider the connection between the norm of decomposable subgroup NGD and norm of abelian non-cyclic subgroup NGA. The fact that they must exist is explained by the fact that the presence of decomposable subgroup in group is directly related to the existence of decomposable abelian subgroup in each, and this subgroup in most cases are non-cyclic. It was found that in the class of locally finite P groups, these norms coincide. The corresponding result is given by theorem 11. And in the class of periodic locally nilpotent non-primary groups, the norm of abelian non-cyclic subgroup contains the norm of decomposable subgroups, and inclusion can be strict. It's a result of theorem 12. In an arbitrary locally finite group containing an abelian non-cyclic subgroup and having a non-Dedekind locally nilpotent norm of decomposable subgroup, these norms coincide. It's a result of the theorem 13. A similar connection between this norm we see in the class of non-periodic group. In particular, the norm of decomposable subgroup is locally nilpotent and non-Dedekind, then it contains the norm of abelian non-cyclic subgroup. Finally, theorem 15 characterizes the connections between this norm, provided that at least one of them is non-Dedekind and the norm NGD is infinite. It is proved that one of these norms is a subgroup of another. The fact that the condition of infinity of the norm NGD in this theorem is essential is confirmed by the following example. You see it on the slide. It's group D, it is group D. In this group, the norm NGD is a finite cyclic subgroup. Norm NGI A is non-periodic non-Dedekind group, and intersection of this norm is identity, and known of this norm is a subgroup of the other. So we can conclude the condition of non-Dedekindness and local nilpotency of norm of the decomposable subgroup is a strong restriction and in many cases allows us to determine the structure of the group. And finally, we present some problems associated with the study of sigma norm of group. These are the study of the properties of sigma norms, the characterization of groups that coincide with their sigma norms, study the properties of groups with sigma norm are non-Dedekind, determining the condition when the sigma norm coincides with the center of a group, study of the properties of groups with the identity sigma norm, study of groups in which the sigma norm has finite non-identity index in group, and study of the relation between different sigma norm and other ways. That is all. Thank you for attention.